anticipated event in our calendar for Carnival every year is undoubtedly the National Carnival Queen Show. Every year, beautiful ladies from all across the island get ready to captivate us with beauty, talent, and intelligence. I had the chance to meet the seven beauties vying for the title this year. I hope you're ready, Sehusha. Here are your enchanting seven. Welcome on set, Jamie. How are you today?
Thank you very much. I'm okay.
Very good. How was this whole experience vying for the title of National Carnival Queen being so far for you?
To a certain extent, it has been a bit challenging coming from Beaufort, but at the same time, it has been worth it because we've been learning a lot of life lessons. For instance, the committee set up some workshop for us where we learned life lessons such as managing fear, and another session with, was it interpersonal skills?
Okay, very nice. How difficult has it been since you said you've been from Beaufort? Can you explain that a bit?
Oh, well, I work at the business office at St. Jude's Hospital, so we have different shifts. And sometimes I have to accommodate or cancel my shifts to be here.
I see. Well, let's fast forward to June 29th, you crowned queen. What is the first cause or charity you support as a queen?
As a queen, the first charity I would support would be to work with the young girls, to encourage them and to advocate for not only beauty on the outside, but for them to portray themselves, their inner beauty, their intelligence, which is important as well.
That's very true. Okay. And you've also stated that you believe Carnival is sensationalized as this one big party. What is true mass in your opinion, and how would you try to regain the culture in Carnival?
To me, true mass would be appreciating, understanding where it all came from, because I was a very good history student at school, so I was able to grab that opportunity to learn about Lucian Mass. And I believe in order for us to come to an understanding of true mass, I believe we should advocate for these teachings at school so that the young children would understand from a very young age.
At least know where they came from, so you don't just jump in Carnival for the whole glitz and the glam and the feathers and the glugla and everything.
Indeed.
Very true. But why have you decided to take part in this pageant this year?
I believe this pageant is an opportunity for me to improve myself. For instance, in terms of public speaking, which I believe is a very vital component of pageantry. It teaches to express yourself, articulation. So I'm hoping to learn this from the pageant.
Very nice. I'm hoping to see much more of that.
Thank you.
A beautiful smile on the 29th of June.
Indeed.
Very nice. Well, good luck.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure. Welcome on set, Soraya. How
Thank
are you?
Thank you. I'm good. And you?
No problem. I'm good. How has this whole experience been for you so
it's
far?
It's been a wonderful experience. I met seven beautiful young ladies.
Yes.
All have wonderful personalities. And we have gotten a great friendship as well in the process. It also helped me boost up my confidence and my public speaking. There are so many things to mention that I have improved in, and I am grateful. I'm so happy that I actually made that decision in my life.
Very nice. Now, one of the things that you have said is that you hope this pageant helps you to recognize a lot of the weaknesses that you have. What is one weakness that you have identified, and how have you improved on it?
At first, my weakness was lack of confidence with my walking and, you know, saying, okay, Sarai, you can do this, and believing in myself. But being in this pageant, I have become so much more confident, and I'm starting to believe in myself more and seeing that I am capable of doing so much. Yes, and also public speaking. So being able to stand in front of a crowd and speak to people, it was nerve-wracking for me. But now, it's nothing.
Well, that's nice that you've grown so far.
Yeah.
But if beauty pageants, a lot of women credit beauty pageants with personal growth.
Mm-hmm.
And from this experience, how would you assist more young women to participate in beauty pageants?
I would let people know out there that everything is worth a try. You know, you might think that you're not capable of this, and you're not capable of being in a pageant. But I thought I wasn't capable of being in a pageant. But in all this experience, I'm like, I want to do more and more and more, and it has done so much for me. So girls out there, come and just have fun in this pageant. It's wonderful. You should try out next year, whoever is looking out there.
Nice. If you were crowned Carnival Queen and you had the power to change one aspect of Carnival, what would it be and why?
I would change the mindset of people because they see Carnival as just having fun on the road and just drinking and getting drunk, but it can be so much. It could be a time for all of us as St. Lucians to come as one and just have fun, no matter our differences. Yes.
Okay, thank you so much. Well, thank you for dropping by, Saraya. I know you have a busy schedule, but I can't wait to see you on the stage on the 29th of June, and good luck.
Thank you so much.
Not a problem. Thanks. So we have a Seven Bell in the house today. What's up, Jamara?
I am fine, thank you.
Good. How has this whole experience been so far?
So far, it's been amazing. I had the pleasure of meeting so many individuals, including the other six contestants. I included myself in that. Yes, it's been good. Coming from down south, I thought it would put a strain on me, but no, it's all positive. I have lots of energy. The excitement for this pageant has kept me going.
You surely seem excited.
Oh, I am excited. And I think the closer it gets to the date, the more excited I become.
Wow, very nice. Now, of course, you just said you're from the south. Born and raised, and I guess you still live there.
Yes, I still live there.
Now, a lot of people comment that persons from the south and persons from the north have a different type of upbringing. I mean, would you believe that to be true? And how has your upbringing prepared you for this type of pageant?
I do not think the individuals from down south and from Kashmir are brought up differently. I think that along the way, people end up being molded into that. So it's not something that they're being brought up differently. Yes, you would say that individuals from the city are more lively and outgoing, and people from the communities are more subtle, but I don't think so. You guys should come down south.
Wow, that's an invitation for us to come down south before
yes,
then.
Yes, it is. I was brought up in a single family with my sister and my brother. My mom brought us up in a religious way, lots of values and morals, and she always encouraged us to achieve our goals, set it high, and aim as high as you can go. So I've always had this drive to achieve anything that I put my mind to.
Now, you describe yourself as being very adventurous, outgoing, optimistic,
yes.
You know, all these kinds of things that just make you who you are.
Oh, yes.
And of course, that's things we'd expect to be seen on June 29th on that stage there. But what is one part of your character that you've developed, or I say discovered, about yourself since entering this pageant?
Since entering this pageant? That's a tricky question. See, because of the sort of person I am, when I entered this pageant, everything that I've gone through has only enhanced the person that I already am. Mm. Naturally, I'm a friendly person. I have this thing about me, it's just boom. So this pageant has brought that out even more. And mingling with the other six contestants, they will tell you.
I guess you're gonna get Miss Congeniality, eh?
You never know, we'll see about that.
Okay, now one of the things that you've commented on is that you've been very adamantly saying that Carnival has the potential to become something much
yes.
bigger than it is. If you are crowned queen, what would you do to play a part to really helping, I guess, the committee or the people that involved make it a bigger event?
For me, Carnival can be bigger, as I said. So I'd first tackle the hotels. That's where I would tackle. I work at Coconut Bay Beach Resort and Spa as the assistant entertainment manager. And what we do every year around the carnival season, we try to bring that experience to the guests at the resort. So we get costumes for them. We have different sections. We have costumes, the t-shirt band, or whether if they just want to come with anything and join in the group, we have slides, foam, poles, you name it. So that's, to me, that's what we should do to try to market St. Lucia. Start it from the hotels, they can have their own carnival. So at least the guests can say, you know what, St. Lucia Carnival next year, I'm not missing it. nothing. Or if it's done before, then they could say, okay, I've got a taste of that. I want the real thing.
That's very good. That's a very interesting suggestion. I know a lot of people don't think of it that way. But again, thank you so much for coming by. We hope to see you, of course, on the 29th.
Thank you.
You're so bubbly and everything else. I mean, you know. I'm kind of in suspense in what else you're going to come up with, right?
Well, all I can say is come June 29th, get your cameras out, make it a date. Please sit front row and enjoy the show.
I don't think you have enough seats front row, Jamara.
I will try to make some space for you.
But thanks once again and good luck.
Thank you very much.
No problem.
Let's take a short break. We have more from our National Carnival Queen contestants when we come back.
Beautiful Zena on set. How are you today, Zena?
I'm fine, thank you.
Feeling yourself? I'm good, Zena. How has the whole experience been for you?
It's been a wonderful experience.
Good.
I've grown as a person. I've met so many beautiful young ladies, built new friendships. It's been a really wonderful experience.
Good. Now, one of the things you stated is that when you were younger, your parents separated and you had to relocate. And you said that was very difficult for you.
Yes.
Now, how easy, or actually how difficult it is for you? I mean, you met up with six different ladies, that's different personalities clashing. How easy has it been for you to handle all of that?
Well, the experience I had from my parents separating, what I did was I brought that into this pageant. So meeting the different girls and different personalities was like, okay, it's a good thing for me because, okay, I met this person, she likes this, maybe she could bring that into me. And like, we exchange personalities and we exchange what we like about one another. So we brought that in, yeah.
Have you said that you would learn different things from the ladies, like certain things that maybe qualities you may want to develop, that you may pick up from a certain person and try to work on it, see how else you can bring it into your personality? Do you think that you have done that?
Yes, I would. Because we have dancers, we have singers, we have actors. So maybe Macy's a dancer, maybe I could meet with her after if I want to dance, if I have something to do, you know?
Learn some moves
from her.
Very nice yes. That you can pick it up and try to make it into your own.
Yes.
So you're learning from this pageant?
Yes, I am.
Good. Now you've competed on a community level,
yes,
Denry as well,
yes,
but you were not able to secure the crown. What motivated you to actually go ahead and take the step and compete in the National Carnival Queen pageant?
Well, the Denry pageant was like, it's a whole plan. I planned to do the Denry pageant, which would give me the experience that was needed for me to do the national pageant. So me not winning the crown wasn't a big problem for me. What I wanted was the experience, and that's what I gained from it. That's why I'm here today in the national pageant.
Very nice.
Yes.
Yeah. Now you describe yourself as being a simple person.
Yes.
Very simple, not too complicated. So what is it that you had to do to make you pageant ready?
Well, on a daily basis, if I was to go to town, I would throw on my jeans, my polo shirt, my slippers in my feet, and off we go. But now, when I'm living home, I have to make sure my hair is well combed, my makeup is on. The slippers, I had to forget about slippers. It's either wedges or a pair of comfortable heels that I would have to dress. You know, because now the Senushan public is looking at you everywhere go.
Yes.
Like, oh, that's a contestant in the Queen show. What shall she watch? So, you know, you had to step up your game.
You know it is already.
Yes.
Very good. Well, I hope to see more of that beautiful smile and your character on full display on June 29th on that stage.
Oh. Yes.
You will, at Senusha, will be seeing that, eh? You will see Zena on the 29th of June.
Yes.
So come out to support her. And good luck, Zena.
Thank you very much.
Not a problem. So we have Miss Extraordinary, the Extraordinary today,
yes,
sitting right here next to me, Michelle. Can you describe your experience in this pageant so far for me?
In this pageant, I must say it's a self-development. I've learned so much from my chaperone especially. She's like a mother to me. I've learned so much about, you know, a lady's attire, a lady's proper attire, and, you know, how to hold myself in public and how to speak, because before I used to speak, I still do, you know, because it's runs in the family. I speak abrupt and, you know, I try to take my time to speak and so on. It's fun. I'm learning so much.
That's very good. That it's a learning experience for you, not just something you just stepped into.
Yes. And it's something win or lose, I will live with. Yes.
Well, that's very true as well. Now, one of the things you always say is that you've always wanted to be part of the Carnival Queen pageant. You used to watch them when you were younger. And what is it, your fondest memory of just watching the queens in the Carnival pageant? And how has it helped you to actually participate in this year's pageant?
When I saw them, like, they're being driven along the road, none didn't really stand out, even if there was, you know, the winner at the very top. And they all looked the same. They all looked, you know, how would I say? Nobody really stand out. Everybody looked, you know, as a team, as a group, they looked very, you know, queenish. And I mean, I can't really explain it. So I said to myself, wow, you know, I want to be a queen. I mean, I didn't have any favorites. I was just like, wow. And, you know, seeing them waving their hands and, you know, their places as they, you know.
Starstruck.
I was just like, and this was the first time I actually got to like see them and knew of, you know, the pageant. Because I asked my mommy, you know, I asked questions, you know me. I asked, she said yes, and I was like, you know, I said to myself, like in my head, I want to be a Carnival Queen.
Oh, she's saying it.
And every year when I keep counting, like, you know, 17, not enough age. 18, well, I did a few pageants, so I was like, okay, next year. And then I did the Campari Caribbean Postal Search, so I couldn't take on it. I was like, next year. This year, I said, I have to do it. I have to, I'm not saying next year, because I wanted, you know, I have to do it. This is my dream. Mm-hmm. And if I don't do it, I feel like as if, you know, I don't know how to explain. Like, I'm, you know, yeah. So I'm here.
You here, and you're gonna be.
I'm doing it. Vying for the crown.
Yes. Vying for the crown on June 29. Now, you said that your mother is a single parent, and that is no easy task. Yes. What is one quality that you've learned from your mother that has helped you in preparing for the pageant?
I would say her consistency, and, you know, her drip, like, she's driven for success, even if, you know, she's single, she's independent, she has a house, she's doing everything for herself. So I remembered, you know, I've come a long way, and, you know, I used to be bullied, I mean, I used to be spit on, you know, just, and I said, you know, one, I remember getting up in the morning, I was like, you know, I need to work on myself, and, you know, I want to put a stop to this, because maybe me being passive, me being very, you know, too nice, or some, you know, being very passive, sorry, I guess that is why, you know, I've been taken advantage of by certain persons at school and so on. And then I started working on myself, participating in pageants, you know, encourage, getting myself in groups, Toastmasters Club, which helped me with you know, public speaking. I don't have any time for that right now because I'm so busy preparing for the show. But yes, so that have helped me to develop, you know, myself as an individual. And today I'm resilient, I'm very confident, I'm happy, I'm strong. I'm happy for myself. I love myself so much. I just can't really explain it. Like, I feel like for once I understood what it is like to love yourself and appreciate and develop yourself. Yeah. So I would encourage any young girl who's out there, you know, just, it wouldn't come to you. It wouldn't come at your doorstep. You need to get up and, you know, whatever you're going through right now, just think about you and, you know, do whatever you have to do. You can do it.
Yeah. Now, you're talking about development. What has this pageant done for you so far for your personal development, your personal growth?
Coming into this pageant, I was a bit, you know, like, I would say I didn't really come as strong. And now I feel more confident. I feel like really me, and this pageant have helped me so much. I mean, so much, just a lot, you know. Yeah, being a young lady, it has helped me so much, you know, just understanding the basics, you know. Like I've said earlier to the radio station, I remember my chaperone used to tell me, oh, a lady needs a white headdress, just, you know, just above the knee, it doesn't have to be too short. No, so I learned that as well. And even the short pants, it doesn't have to be party rider, you know, like we say. It has to be, you know, a little long. I've learned so much.
Little girly things that you need.
Yes, because I try to, you know, dress decent, but what I think is decent is not decent. You know what I mean? So I've learned so much.
Oh, along.
I've learned so much.
Well, it's good that at least you grew, you learned, and you're developing into a woman, and this is what this pageant is doing for you. So we hope to see more of that in all the different segments, so you can blossom on the 29th on that stage. So the whole of St. Lucia will be watching you to see you home with your friend.
Yes, come support me.
Oh yes. So good luck. Let's be extraordinary.
Yes. Thank you so much.
No problem.
Thanks. Thank you for having me, Joelle.
Yeah. So today we have Miss St. Lucia Tourist Board, Amy, in the house. What's up, Amy?
Hi, I'm doing okay. Thank you.
Very good. How has this whole experience been for you so far?
This experience has been good. Of course, there are some down moments, but it's been good so far.
Very nice. Now, one of the things about you, you credit the whole village of Ancillary in bringing you up and developing you as a person. Can you elaborate on that a bit for me?
Well, in terms of my upbringing, I've been primarily involved with the deceased Petrolina de Tourville, and her contribution in terms of the village of Ancillary has been one that is very magnificent in terms of the music. And from a tender age, I was under her guidance, taking part in a lot of productions, primarily with the group Sicilian Rays, which is a group my family is also very involved with. My mother sings with the group, my brother plays the clarinet, my brother, older brother plays the keyboard, my dad plays the guitar.
Wow.
Yeah.
So your whole family is musically inclined.
Yes.
Nice. Now, one of the things that really shines out about you is that you're very culturally involved. You're in theater arts, you're in all different groups, and of course you love to sing. But in terms of pageantry, or the festival on its whole, do you think that the culture has been lost at all?
The culture of pageantry, you mean?
Well, carnival in itself. Do you think the whole culture has been lost?
I wouldn't say the culture has been lost. I would say, of course, there are some challenges with the cultural form today. And I must commend the efforts to actually mobilize the cultural form and making some changes. And I mean, carnival has its connotations as well. Certain people view it as a negative, in a negative light. Some people merely view it as something that is very entertaining, very fun. However, there is always room for improvement, so I wouldn't say it's lost.
Okay. Yep. Now, if you had to re-energize carnival, how would you inject your own suggestion into the whole carnival festival? How would you put much more of artistic expression into the festival?
First of all, I think to actually get the carnival festival, give it a bit more hype, I think preparation would be very important. So for example, look at Trinidad. As soon as carnival is over, they start their preparation on the go. I think that is something that is very important. With better preparation, it means you can invite more artists to come on board. Their music will be out earlier, dancers are ready, dancing to the tracks. I mean, things are ready, and come July, we're selling a better package.
Very true. Very good suggestion. But of course, we are waiting to see you on the 29th of June at the National Cultural Center, and good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
Not a problem. Welcome on set, Macy, and you're one of the seven beautiful ladies that'll be vying for the title of National Carnival Queen.
Yes, I am.
And how has it been so far for you?
But it's been a great experience. I've been learning a lot of things that I may not even know about myself. I've been learning to better develop myself, so it's a lovely experience. I'm loving it so far.
Now, one of the things that really got me about you is that you said that you were a dancer.
Yes.
So in terms of expression, it's nothing new to you. However, you did say that when it comes to verbally expressing yourself, it's kind of difficult for you to say what you need to.
Yes.
So how has this pageant helped you to better that about yourself?
You know, there is the interview section of it, and being somebody involved in the whole field of pageantry, you have to be an all-rounder. So you have to nail the walk, nail the talent, nail the interview. So I've been learning for the past 2 months how to better express myself, how to better interact with persons. So on the night of the show, I could come and nail that interview.
So you come and hit them hard on June 29th. Now, one of the things that you said in your bio that you wanted to become a criminal officer. Now, that career path is a little far off from pageantry. So what is common about the two that actually attracted you to take on both?
Well, basically, my main goal is to just help society. I want to contribute positively to society.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe through criminal justice, I could do that. I could bring happiness to people, knowing that the society could be a safer place after my contribution in it.
Mm-hmm.
So that is basically why I chose that field. And also with dance, I could bring happiness to persons, as through my performance, they could just have a wonderful experience, and through that alone, could bring happiness to them.
Very nice, Macy. Now, of course, being in a beauty pageant, you know, there are a lot of things people say about girls involved in the pageants and this and that. What is one myth that you have found out to be false, and why?
Persons usually say that being involved in a pageant is just beauty. It's only beauty. But it's so much more than that. Because, like I mentioned earlier, there's the interview segment, mm-hmm. and there should be a level of intelligence if you want to go forth with such a segment. Mm-hmm. So the myth would be that it's not only about beauty, but you have to be an all-rounder individual. You have to have beauty, grace, poise, intelligence, and that's pretty much all what it's covered.
Thank you so much, Macy, for dropping by, and we will see you, of course, on Saturday, June 29th, and good luck.
Thank you for having me.
No problem.
It was an absolute pleasure getting the chance to speak with you and discovering your passions. Good luck to you all, and see you on June 29th.